If I do this slowly. Oh, wait. We do it one more time. From here. One, two.
When the key like disappeared and it came back, like felt like a little tug on the chain, and then it just was there, and I was like, what?
At the beginning, I think Repo was just one chain that disappeared in my left hand and reappeared out of thin air on my fingertips. When I showed it to all my magician friends, they were really looking and they couldn't find a way to reconstruct where this goes and how it comes back.
Magic in my own hands. I have no idea how we did it.
This is just a really nice feeling if you get your magicians around you asking you, how is it done?
He was able to place the chain onto my hand and transform it into a key somehow. It was nuts.
If you break it down and look at the chain itself and you see that it's made out of little small connections that go full circle, combined with a key that stands for symbolically for so many open possibilities. You created something out of that moment, giving you so much freedom to work with. Look at this. The more I imagine the things, the more they become reality. This is the room of imagination. In this room, everything is possible. But the funny part is, it's not about that key or something, right? Because that key never existed. It's all about that chain. Yeah, check it out. Can you open your hand for me? Sometimes the imagination, right, is just the key to your reality.
How in the world? Oh my God.
We're going to take it slowly. Now check this out. One, two. Goes back to you. I think a simple chain is something that everybody can connect with and has so many options to it, so it's just a beautiful tool.
It was a chain! How in the world that it felt in my hand?
Me as a magician, I always have this preference that it's an experience for the spectator, so if it happens in their hands, the better. Can you open your hand? Yeah, check this out. If I put it just in your hand, like this, it's actually the key.
Wait.
It's the key of imagination.
Dude,
it was magic, man. That's all I can say. It was magic.
And I love to perform this because it's so elegant. It's a really beautiful moment when some jewelry appears in midair. And I can play this object in a frame where I have it up on eye level and everybody can see it. You know what? This key that never existed. You know, this is like, there are so many factors come together why I love this effect so much.
How are you doing it?